In this problem, the if component is the given component. If two angles and included side, two angles and the included side BC of one triangle, if two angles and included side of one triangle is equal to the similar same angles and the side of another triangle, this is the given component. Then two triangles are congruent. That is the two proof component. So ABC congruent PQR need be proved, and the given component is two angles and included side of two triangles such that B equals Q, C equals R, and the included side in between these two angles is BC equals QR, side BC equals QR. This appears to be a simple proof, but there are three possibilities, case 1, case 2, and case 3 for this proof. Let us assume AB equals to PQ, angle B equals to angle Q, and BC equals to QR, line segment. This is assumed, this is given, and this is also given. Therefore, triangle ABC congruent triangle PQR by SAS congruence criterion. In the first assumption, we have taken AB equals PQ. In the second assumption, we will say that AB is greater than PQ. Somewhere here, let there be a point M, then MB equals to PQ. We have assumed AB is greater than PQ for case 2. For case 1, we have assumed AB equals to PQ. For case 2, we assume AB is greater than PQ. So we pick a point between A and B where a point M equals PQ. Therefore, MB is equal to PQ and the rest all remains the same, and BC equals to QR. These two are the given components, and this is the arrived component, and this is the assumed component arrived by construction. Now we have triangle MBC is congruent to triangle PQR by SAS congruence criterion. Now here comes the critical beautiful explanation of this theorem. It is given that angle B equals to angle Q, and this angle is equal to this angle, and if this angle needs to be equal to this angle, then A should fall on to M, and therefore A obviously should coincide with M. So we write, since angle B equals to angle Q and angle ACB equals to angle PRQ, this is the given components of the theorem. The given components. And if this got to be true, A should fall back onto M and A should coincide with M. A coincides with M, and therefore AB equals to PQ, and therefore triangle ABC congruent triangle PQR if and only if A comes on to M and AM AB is corresponding to PQ or congruent to PQ. And now case 3, we can take the converse argument that AB is less than PQ, and by the same steps we can argue that A should necessarily coincide, A is less than PQ. A is less than PQ, that is A falls somewhere here and point N need be created, and A should necessarily coincide with point N in order to arrive at the SAS congruence, as has been explained and elaborated in case 2.